Hello students, I am Professor Santosh Kabir. I am teaching these subjects for last 7 to 8 years. I am teaching CP1, CP2, data structures, internet programming and like all computer IT subjects I teach. Today we will be starting with CP2, that is Java. And today we will take introduction to Java first. We will first discuss the syllabus of Java and then we will start the proper topics. you already studied CP1 and in that we used a language called as C++. It's again an object-oriented programming language, but it's not a 100% object-oriented programming language. It uses OOP, but it's not a 100% OOP language. Now, let's talk about what is the compiling processes. You are not compiling your programs, but then why compiling is required exactly, that you will understand first. Since we are writing our programs in C++ or Java or Visual Basic or such kind of languages, these languages are high level languages. Even Java is also a high level language. The programs written in Java or C++ or Visual Basic will not be understood by computer's machine. So we have to make it understand. How to make it understand? We have to convert these instructions which are written in C++ or Java or Visual Basic into its own language, that is called as machine language or low level language. Now to convert this C++ or Java or other language instructions we have done into machine language, we need something called as a compiler. Now what is a compiler? A compiler is a program which is there built in your PC with the software that you install, like Java, C++, there are different compilers are available. So when you are using C++, you will be converting your program into machine language using a C++ compiler. So what it does, it converts a high level language program into low level language program, that is machine language. Yeah. Now I have written this program, for example, let's say on Windows or for Windows. A program written for Windows we compile into machine language. It can work on a machine that has Windows or any version of Windows, like Windows 7, XP or Windows 2000 or even old Windows like Windows 3.1 or 95 also. The program can run on particular machine only. So it becomes a machine dependent or platform dependent language. A C++, Visual Basic or Pascal, Fortran, whatever languages are there, old languages other than Java, they are called as platform dependent, that is machine dependent languages, because the program written in those languages are converted into machine language which can work for particular kind of machine only. They won't work on any other machine. For example, a program written for Windows, a C++ program written on Windows and compiled, cannot work on a Unix machine, cannot work on a Linux machine or a Mac operating system. But in Java, as a Java, Sun Microsystems claim that a Java program can be compiled and the compiled program can be executed on any machine, that is any kind of environment, and that's why Java becomes a platform independent language. Now how is that made possible? That you have to understand, it is the main feature of Java, that is platform independence. Java is completely platform independent language because a program written in Java can be compiled and run on any machine. As the Sun Microsystems, there is a developer, the main company who has developed that language, they claim that it can run on any machine. Now how it is possible, that also you have to see. Yeah, so first we'll discuss the syllabus of CP2 and then discuss all these small features of Java and all. Yeah, so let's start with the syllabus first. Yeah, the topics will be studying, that is syllabus will be studying for CP2 is, first is Java language features, that is overall what Java is all about, what are different features, what are things present in Java, what will you be learning. Then we will be learning Java basics as a language, what Java consists of, like operators, variables, how to write arrays, how to use 2D arrays, how to use classes, objects, very basic concepts of classes, objects, we'll be studying here. Then we'll be studying OOP concepts in Java. The same thing that we have already studied in CP1, that is classes, objects, inheritance, overloading method, overriding methods, all those concepts we'll be studying in OOP. Then inheritance. We'll study inheritance as a separate topic because there's a lot of things to do in Java. It has something called as interfaces, it has something called as abstract classes, which are not present in C++. So it'll be a separate topic we'll be studying. Then we'll study exception handling, a very powerful feature to handle runtime errors. Exception stands for runtime error. Java can handle runtime errors very delicately and very nicely, and with very nice way of handling it. Next is packages. We'll be studying a very small topic. You can study that anytime. You can start without a package also, no problem. Yeah. Seventh is java.lang package, a special package we'll be studying. Then we'll be studying one topic called as collection and utility classes. Second last is applets and graphic programming. In Java, we can write two kind of programs. First is called as application program, a program which can run on desktop. A normal program that we write in C++, like black and white screen, text application, or it can be a Windows application also, but that is called as a simple application programming. And applet program is a program that can run on browser. Only with the help of browser, the applet program can run or it cannot run. Next is multithreading. What is multithreading is? We know what is multitasking is. Multitasking stands for multiple programs, multiple processes can be working in your PC at a time. But multithreading stands for multiple parts of single program can be working at a time in your PC, that is called as multithreading. One thread is one part of a program. So there can be multiple parts of same program, single program working at a time. And that is also done by Java in very delicate way, very nice way. And that we will be studying as the last topic, bit complicated topic, but we will be studying only what is required for our syllabus, not other than that. Yeah, so that is how syllabus is